Mr. Niranjan Adhikari, Chief Advisor, Quest Nepal. Mr. Niranjan Adhikari, Chief Advisor, Quest Nepal.
And now I request ma'am, Dr. Jasveer Kaur Chahal is here. Oh, sorry, Niranjan Adhikari, first I want to say, sorry, bypassing the things. Okay.
Thank you very much, Dr. Purohit. Here we have many points and arguments from our expert panelist. I'm in line with the ideas and the points that has come up to now. When I see the topic of today's panel discussion, I started thinking about where are the problems in the classroom. We are thinking of the new trends and the pedagogical changes that we can bring in our classroom to make our learners more rich with knowledge and skills. Actually, we have hundreds of students in this hall, and we cannot ignore the voice and the choices of our students. Before we enter into the classroom, we need to calculate what are the voices and what are the choices of our students. As a teacher, if we are not able to identify the actual need and the aspiration of the students, I think the real learning cannot happen in the classroom. So I shall ask all our students here in the hall one question. Are you satisfied and happy with 40 minutes or 1 hour teaching in the classroom? Are you happy, dear children? Do you say that we entertain each and every second in the classroom with our teachers in the school? In my observation, you may not be able to say the realities that is happening in the classroom, but in my observation, I'm pretty sure that our students are not happy and satisfied with the way that we are teaching in the classroom, because we are not able to catch the voice and the choice of the student in the classroom. I think our students will agree with this. For this, what kind of classroom environment we can create? Why don't we think of a student's quality circle approach in which we have been working for last 15 years as a new trend, new pedagogy to practice in our classroom? I'm thinking about it. I want to propose in this August gathering of the quality experts and the educationists, along with the emerging quality leaders of this world, that students' quality circle approach has been applied as an integral part of learning activity in the classroom. Not only that, it has been developed as the curriculum. In Nepal, we have practiced SQC, students' quality circles approaches, its tools, its techniques, as a curriculum in the classroom. In classes 6 and 7 and 8, we have a specific curriculum on the basis of which our teachers go in the classroom and they deal with the problems of the student. That might be academic problem, that might be behavioral problems, or that might be psychosocial problems of the student. They identify, they analyze and solve their own problems by themselves. We can form a small teams of 4 to 10 students in the classroom, and in each subject, besides having the knowledge of mathematics, science, history, geography, whatsoever, the 21st century skills, the collaboration skill, the leadership skill, the problem solving skill, the communication skill, there are so many skills that we need to inculcate in the minds and heart of our students so that they can be able and a very quality human resources in the future, for which our teachers, if they only become a teacher to teach something, our students are not able to listen to our teachers. Actually, we want our teacher to be a facilitator and learn something in the classroom by doing something. Learning by doing. We have been saying these things for last 10 years, 15 years, but we are not able to practice it in the classroom. So our experiences prove that we can use students' quality circles approaches, its tools, its techniques, and its methodology to teach all the subjects in our classrooms where students participate. They don't listen to the teachers. They participate in the real life problems they are facing in the school, in the society, and at home. So I think we can just think of introducing students' quality circle as an integral part of our academic activities in the school and in the classroom. Thank you very much, Dr. Purohit.
Thank you, Narendra sir. You very rightly said, because classroom atmosphere is really required to be generated over there, so that they can participate and they can interact very particular on the every subjects and give them insight to them so that they can involve, they can engage toward the study and attract toward the subjects on the things. Thank you very much.
Teachers also need to be given their due so that they can do their work